हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू नागेश करजगी ऑर्किड चैनल। आई एम मीना टीचर टीचिंग यू थर्ड स्टैंडर्ड साइंस। व्हाट वी हैव स्टडीड इन आवर लास्ट सेशन? यस, टेल मी। यस, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड आवर फिफ्थ चैप्टर द अर्थ, इजंट इट? सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, बट बिफोर दैट आई वुड लाइक टू आस्क यू वन क्वेश्चन। डू यू थिंक लाइफ इज पॉसिबल ऑन द अर्थ विदाउट द सन? Yes, is it possible? As we have studied in the chapter the earth, yes, we have studied how important the sun is, isn't it? If on the earth there is no sun, we could not see anything. Everywhere full darkness will be there. Now how light is there? Because of the sun. Sun gives us sunlight. So without sun the life is very very impossible, isn't it? Now my next question, what do you see in the sky at the night? Yes, what do you see? Tell me, what do you see in the sky at night? Yes, you are correct, you see stars in the sky as well as you see moon also, isn't it? Now can you see the stars during the day? Can you see the stars during the day? No. Why we cannot see stars during the day? Tell me. See, actually the stars also, they are having the stars also like huge balls, isn't it? So whenever and why they are shining at the night? Because of the sun reflection only. They don't have their own light. Even moon also, they don't have their own light. Stars and moon also, like earth only, they are also one huge ball. And when sun reflect on them, that time they shines on the earth. So I think you are getting now what we are going to study. Today we are going to study the sun, moon and stars. It's a very interesting topic, so I hope you like this topic. Now what you are going to do, now you have to open your canopy. First we will read the chapter, then I'll explain each and every point. Now open your canopy, page number 3838. Now what I'll do, I'll play the audio of the reading and you people keep your finger on each and every line. Okay? Shall we start? I hope everyone have opened your canopy. Page number 3838. Let's start.
The sun, moon and stars.
Learning objectives. By the end of the lesson, you will be able to describe the sun and the solar system. Explain what constellations are. State why the moon appears to change its shape every day. Mind open. Look at the sky at night. What do you see? Look at the sky during the day. How is the sky at night different from the sky during the day?
The sun. The sun is the brightest object in the sky. It is a huge ball of very hot gas. It gives heat and light. Without heat and light, there would be no life on the earth. The sun is a star. It is the star closest to the earth. The sun's time. A planet is a huge object that goes around a star. Planets do not have their own life. The sun has 8 planets that revolve around it. The earth is one of these planets. The sun and its 8 planets belong to the solar system.
Next page.
Stars. On a clear night, you can see thousands of stars twinkling in the sky. All stars are huge balls of hot gases. In the olden days, people used their imagination to connect several stars to form a shape or a pattern in the sky. These groups of stars forming an imaginary shape or pattern in the sky are called constellations. Constellations have been named after animals or people from ancient myths. The great bear, Orion, the hunter, Leo, Canis Major, and Hercules are examples of constellations.
Turn the next page.
The moon. The moon is a ball of rock that revolves around the earth. It is our nearest neighbor in space. It has no light of its own and is lit up by the light from the sun. When the moon goes around the earth, different parts of it are lit by the sun on different days. We can only see the part that is lit up. So it looks as if the moon changes its shape every day. When the moon is between the sun and the earth, the side of the moon facing us does not get sunlight. So we cannot see the moon because its dark side faces us. This is the new moon. After a day or two, we see a small portion of the moon. This is called the crescent moon. After 7 days, we can see half the moon. This is the half moon. 2 or 3 days later, we can see more than half the moon. This is called the gibbous moon. 2 weeks after the new moon, the moon is on the opposite side. The side facing us gets sunlight. We can now see the full moon. The different shapes of the moon as seen from the earth are called the phases of the moon. It takes the moon nearly 28 days to go around the earth. So the number of days between one new moon and the next is 28 days.
Okay, now close your canopy. So today we are going to study deeply the lesson number 6, the sun, moon and stars. So in this chapter we are going to study about the sun and the solar system, and you will be able to know that what is constellations are, and at last you are going to study that why the moon appears to change its shape every day. Okay, in that the first point, the sun. Now you know everyone sun, isn't it? Sun gives us light, you know about it. You have studied about sun deeply in the last chapter, the earth, isn't it? Yes, the sun is the brightest object in the sky. It is a huge ball of very hot gases. You can see picture, I had given the sun picture. See, it looks like just circle in orange or sometimes yellow color. But when you go near to sky that time, if you see the sun, it looks like in this way. You can see in the picture. See, the sun is very huge ball of very hot gases. It's very hot. We cannot go near the sun at all. Okay. And it gives us heat and light. Who gives us heat and light? Sun. Sun gives us heat and light. Without heat and light, there would be no life on the earth. See what they are saying? Without heat and light, there would be no life on the earth. Is it correct? Yes. Now you say that lights are there, na teacher? Yes, but how we will on the switch? To on the switch, we should see something. Where is the switch? Where to go? How to on? Everything, isn't it? And what about heat? Yes, if heat is not there, there would be cold only. So every time you used to wear the sweaters and use it all day and night, no, it's not possible. So heat and light is very important, which we are getting from the sun. So without heat and light, there would be no life on the earth, isn't it? Earth is there. There are so many people lives on the earth. And how we can see this world? Yes, because of the sunlight. And that light we get from sun. The sun is a star. See what they are saying. As we see at night, there are many stars in the sky. And same, the sun is also star. Who is star? The sun is also star. And it is the star that is closest to the earth. See, this star means sun is closest to the earth, which is near to earth. Okay, have you understood? Yes. About the sun we have studied. Now the next, the sun's family. See, sun is also having family. You do have family na? Yes. How many members are there in your family? Tell me. How many members are there? Yes, some may have 4, some may have 5, joint families there, 10, 12, isn't it? Mother, father, grandpa, grandma, sister, brother, uncle, aunt, in this way. At the same time, here they say, we are going to study about the sun's family. See, sun also having family. A planet is a huge object that goes around the star. See, a planet is a huge object that goes around the star. Planets do not have their own lights. The sun has 8 planets that revolve around it. The earth is the one of these planets. See, near the sun there are 8 members. Okay, they are known as the solar system. I will show you the members of the sun's family. So they called as a planets. What they called? Planets. And how they are? The planet is a huge object that goes around the sun. So the how the earth moves around the sun, at the same time there are many planets that all moves around the sun. So planets do not have their own light. As the earth don't have their own light, at the same time even planets, they don't have their own lights. The sun has 8 planets that revolve around it. See, around the sun there are 8 planets, they revolve around it. Revolve means, yes, revolve means they move around, they take rounds around the sun. Okay, the earth is one of these planets. In that 8 planet, only one of the planets is earth. The suns and its 8 planets belong to the solar system. Now you can see in this picture there are 8 planets which stay near the sun, and they all are huge object that goes around a star. See how they look. They are looking like all planets. They are planet. They are called as a planet. Now you can see the first planet which is near to sun. Yes, can you see here? Mercury. How many first we will count? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. See how many planets are there? 8 planets. So the sun, in sun's family, how many members are there? 8 members. Okay, the first planet name is Mercury, which is smallest planet. Okay, and the second one is Venus. You can see here Venus. And the third one is Earth, and fourth Mars, and the fifth one Jupiter, and the sixth one, see everyone, yes, Saturn, and the seventh one Uranus, and the eighth one, Neptune. So these are the planets. These revolves around the sun. How Earth takes, see, we have studied in the Earth, Earth take one round itself, it takes one day, isn't it? In 24 hours, the Earth completes one round himself. And if the Earth want to complete one round around the sun, it takes 365 days, means 1 year. How Earth moves around the sun, Earth revolve, moves means revolve. At the same time, these all planets also takes round around the sun. Okay, so have you understood the solar system? Yes, there are 8 planets in the solar system. This is the sun's family. Okay, keep in your mind. Now we'll move to the next point, that is the stars. Now what is stars? On the clear night, you can see the thousands of stars twinkling in the sky, isn't it? See, you can see when the clear night is there, means when dark night is there, that time, can we count the stars? Yes. Students, tell me, do you like to count the stars? Even I like to count the stars, but we cannot count the huge sky. How we can count? If we are counting also, we can see thousands of the stars twinkling in the sky, isn't it? So it's very impossible to count the stars in the sky. So we can see the stars are very small from ground where we stay, but they are not small. All stars are huge balls of hot gases. How the sun is huge ball of hot gases, at the same time even the stars also huge balls of hot gases, isn't it? So you don't say that stars comes at night means they are very cool. Not at all. At night time we don't feel hot, isn't it? We feel cool. But these stars are not cool, they are also huge balls of hot gases. They are filled with hot gases only. See, in the olden days, people used their imagination to connect several stars to form a shape of a or pattern in the sky. See, what they do in olden days, whenever they see stars in the sky, they used to join those stars with the imagination. What they used to do? They used to join that all stars with the imagination. See, the pattern means what? The regular arrangement of lines, shapes and colors. Pattern means what? The regular arrangement of lines, shape and colors. So what they used to do? They used to imagine to connect the several stars. They used to join stars with the hand, with the imagination. Okay, they used to make their own pattern. See, in this way, can you see the picture? Yes, by using their own imagination. Everyone imagination will be different, isn't it? So these group of stars from forming an imaginary shape or pattern in the sky are called constellation. What is constellations? When the stars forming an imaginary shape or pattern in the sky are called constellation. Keep in your mind. Okay, these are the stars. You can see in the picture there are many stars. So in olden days, what people used to do? They use their imagination to connect the several stars to form a shape or pattern in the sky. Can you see? You can also do this activity, okay, at home. Whenever you see at night stars, you can make any shape, isn't it? Yes. Mother draw rangoli or no with the dots? Yes. Yes, you also imagine the rangoli in the sky with the imagination. Join the dots and imagine. See, with the dots we used to draw dog also, isn't it? Dog, cat, even bird also, isn't it? You can imagine anything. Now here you can see that you can imagine like kite, isn't it? Kite is flying in the sky, the picture you can see. So what is mean by constellation here? When the group of stars forming an imaginary shape or pattern in the sky are called constellations. Understood? Clear till here? Yes. Now, constellations have been named after animals or people from ancient myths. See what they are saying? He is a ancient myth. Myths means what? A story from olden days which may or may not be true. It is may be true or it may be may not be true. So the great bear Orion, the hunter Leo, Canis Major and the Hercules are example of constellation. So these are famous myths. They form a story which may be true or which may not be true. Okay, so they have formed these after animals or people from ancient myths. Okay, clear till here? Now we'll move to the next point, that is the moon. The moon. Now, you know the moon? Yes. The moon is a ball of rock that revolves around the earth. See, even moon also ball of rock. Even that revolves around the earth. Now, see, the moon revolves around the earth. It is our nearest neighbor in space. See, it is. Who is nearest neighbor in space? The moon. The moon is nearest neighbor in space. It has no light of its own and it lit up by the light from the sun. See, actually the moon don't have their own light. But how we can see the moon in the sky? Because of the sun reflect, because of the sunlight. So when the moon sun reflect on the moon, that time we can see the moon in the sky. Are you getting? Yes, this is very important. So keep in your mind that moon don't have their own light. So it has no light of its own and it's lit up by the light from the sun, which get light from the sun only. Now when the moon goes around the earth, different part of it are lit up by the sun on different days. See what they are saying? When the moon goes around the earth, see how the earth revolves around the sun. At the same time, when moon goes around the earth, different part of it lit up by the sun on different day. And we can see only part of that it lit up. So it looks like the moon changes its shape every day. Now see, sometimes we don't see the complete moon, isn't it? How we see? Sometimes you see the moon in this way, isn't it? Why it look like in this way? Sometimes it looks in this way, in oval shape. Sometimes very small you see, isn't it? Sometimes we see full moon, isn't it? Sometimes you see in this way. Why these oval shapes comes? Why moon changes its shape every day? Tell me. Yes. Because the moon takes round, means revolves around the earth. So whenever it's revolves around the earth, that time the sun, how much the sun gives light. See, here you can see the earth. So this is the moon which revolves around the earth, and here is the sun. So how sun reflect on the moon, that much only we can see the moon, because the moon don't have their its own light, isn't it? So when it's the moon don't have its own light, so whatever the sun reflect on the moon, that much only we could see the moon in the sky every day. Okay, so at in which day it looks like, means in day 3, 7, 10, how it looks we are going to study. For a whole month, how the moon looks, we will study deeply now. Okay, when the moon is between the sun and the earth, the side of the moon facing does not get sunlight. See what they are saying. When the moon is between earth and sun, now you have seen in the last picture only. See here. Where is the moon? See, it is between the earth and sun, isn't it? So when it moves and when it comes exactly between the sun and the earth, the side of the moon facing does not get sunlight. So that time the moon does not get sunlight. So we cannot see the moon because of its dark side faces us. So sometimes we see very dark moon in the sky, isn't it? Why it looks? Because when the moon is between the sun and the earth, so that time, so when the moon is between the sun and the earth, the side of moon facing does not get the sunlight. So that's why we cannot see the dark moon side faces us. So this is what? This is the new moon. This is what? New moon. So when we cannot see the moon, so when we see the dark side of face of the moon is known as a new moon. Keep in your mind. When it is fully dark, when it is fully dark, we cannot see the moon because of the dark side faces of the dark side faces us, the moon. When the dark side faces us, that time we cannot see the moon. We can see like this dark face of moon. So this is known as a new moon. Keep in your mind. Okay, now next. See, after a day or 2 days, we see a small portion of the moon. Now see, the first day when the new moon was there, that time we could see only full dark. Then after that, within 1 or 2 days, we can see a small portion of the moon. So this is called crescent moon. What it is called? Crescent moon. Now you can see in this picture. So when it was full dark, then within 1 or 2 days we can see this much part only. Yes, this is called crescent moon. Are you getting, students? Yes, are you getting? Okay, so today here we will wind up our today's session. It's time to wind up. Now the remaining part of the moon we will study in our next coming session. Now what is your today's home assignment? Yes, you observe the day. What do you see in the day and what do you see at the night? You just observe and make the list of the things and write in your rough book and read the chapter lesson number 6 on page number 38-39. These two pages you read the sun, sun's family and star. Read, underline the hard words which you feel hard, write those hard words in rub book 3 times and learn the spellings. Okay? Now we will meet in our next session with the remaining points. Till that time, bye bye, take care and thank you.